how to create the chart. So the first step is selecting the data. It's better to exclude totals for now. After selecting data, we press Alt F1. It's the quickest way to create a default chart, which is column chart, as you see. Another method is simply click on a cell of our data and press again Alt F1. Excel is smart enough to select all the data of the table. But if we have sums, averages and totals, it's not the best method. If we want to select non-adjacent area, we will use the control key. For example, we highlight these cells from the first column and then pressing control and highlight these cells of the E column. And then, of course, we press again Alt F1. Until now, we created a chart on the same worksheet with our data. But sometimes it's better to have a chart on a new worksheet. This method is simple. We highlight the cells of our data with mouse and then we press F11 key. A chart will appear on a new worksheet called Chart 1. By making changes to the values of data, the chart will be changing. For example, we go to worksheet chart types, cell B9, put 100 and we see the change for our chart. When we select data in the lower right corner, a quick analysis tool appears. We can, for example, create a chart from this tool very easy. Pretty fast method. If default chart isn't that we want, then after selecting data, we click Insert tab from the ribbon. And we see a number of choices relating to specific chart types. Each category of a chart has many choices, simply by clicking the arrow or the icon itself. Finally, the recommended chart feature. It's again on the Insert tab and is ideally for new Excel users. A nice feature in Excel 2013 is Sparklines. It's a chart inside the cell and it's not as small as you think. Let's click to Sparklines worksheet. We want to show a chart for each row independently, all the way down the column. So first we highlighting these cells, then we click on the Insert tab. We see that we have three different kinds of sparklines, line, column and win-loss. Let's click on line. A new window appears. We click on data range and we highlight these specific cells. Be careful, only the numbers. Then press OK. We see our line charts, one for each cell. If we want to make some changes, like color, we click on Design tab. Then we can click from Style a different one. Also, we can show high points or low points of the chart. Useful also is axis button. Let's click on it. Now we will try to insert a different kind of spark line. Let's highlight these cells, click Insert tab and Column. Click on the data range and highlight the same cells, and OK. If we have positive and negative numbers, then an ideal choice is win-loss chart. Thanks for watching. Yeah.